Hey y'all, Sarah Luhu here, and we are back again with Nightcry. So last time we rescued Kelly, we fought off a baby doll, and we have made our way into this kind of storage area where Kelly, Maria, our bitch teacher who has a huge crush on Leonard and wishes that Rudy was dead and Leonard was with her, is here, along with this woman, this guy, and Vigo creeping in the background. I see you back there, you creeping fucking... Yeah, he's the one running this ship. I bet you anything he's the one responsible for all of this. I'm really just circling that mouse. Anywho, so we talked to Maria, let's talk to Kelly. We haven't talked to Kelly yet, I don't think. Nothing's getting through that door. We should be safe hunkering down here until help arrives. Help is coming? Why, yes, Leonard sent out a stress signal, right? Hell if I know, but now shit's hit the fan. Someone on the crew must have something. Anyway, did you see Monica or Jessica on your way over? I didn't. I can't reach them by phone or text. I know I haven't seen them. That's true, we have not. Damn, I'm sure they stood away somewhere safe, just like us, though. Let's see. Monica should be lower down on the ship, right? That's where Creepy Itches was saying he was going with her, so... If we go down, we might be able to find her. Oh, I'm going to go look for Monica! Good for you, Rooney! What, are you serious? I mean, yeah, why would you want to look for her, but... Yes, and also the professor and Jessica. We haven't confirmed everyone is safe, after all. Taking action, Rooney? Gee, wow, you really do have a death wish. You know there's a murderous freak on the rampage out there. I'm aware of that, but I also want to find out what the way... I also want to find a way out of this crisis. Whoa, since when were you the proactive type? Yeah, action woman Rooney over here. Oh, right, your death wish must have busted your instincts for survival. Okay. Do you mean been busted by? Oh, we're going to have an awkward silence again. Ah, hell. It's your life. Go throw it away. See if I care. Kelly cares so much. Do you have Monica or Jessica's contact details? No, we do not. You should totally give us those. I mean, Jessica's dead, but Monica we can still... Right, you never qualified to be a member of the bitch brigade. Hold up, I'll send you the details your way. Yay. So now we have... contact details. And we have contact... There we go. Golly, why was that taking so long to wear off? Wait, was that all you had to say? I don't know, usually. Listen, it's not just you and me using this place to hide. Well, yeah, it's a bunch of people. Everyone back here wants to make it out of this alive. Okay, so if you come running back here with that freak on your tail, there's no way I'm opening this door. That is completely understandable. I won't do anything to lead it back here. Damn straight. Don't let your guard down out there. I love how Rudy is just kind of like stomping and almost shouting at people. You might be a loony with a death wish, but I'd feel better waking up in the morning if I know people aren't murdered. If people I know aren't murdered. Okay. So, who are you? Nice to meet you. I'm Rooney. I'm assuming that's all she had to say to us. My, my, it takes a special kind of person to greet someone so normally in these circumstances. You only got in here a while ago, right? Did you come across any survivors out there? I can't find my husband. John Thompson, he's super dead. Maybe you've heard something. No, I've not talked to any of the survivors other than Kelly and an acquaintance. Why are you stomping and yelling at her, okay? No, I haven't found nobody! At the end of the day, he's a very capable man. He's probably safe some sound somewhere. Seriously, Rooney, take it down like 10 notches, please. I overheard you're going to find, your friends, aren't you? Yes, yes we are. And also, if I stay here, I'll never know if there's a way to escape, what? True, you're a brave one. If you're going, you'll need your friend's contact details. Monica, wasn't it? Oh, I got her contact details from Kelly just now! Seriously, stop screaming at her, but not these details. The number to my husband's smartphone! You see, a little while ago, I called my husband's smartphone, and a girl called Monica answered. She said she found his smartphone lying around. Maybe she... Okay, whatever. I see, so I might be able to get her through John's number. Exactly, he take down John's number. Okay, that is actually pretty awesome. I did not think of that. Because we did, we picked up John's phone. We don't have Monica's phone. So now we have... Oh, look at our list of friends. They're just growing. Okay, we got John, we got Jessica, we got Monica, Kelly, Leonard, Maria. Bitch. And is that all? I called John's smartphone several times trying to get back in touch with Monica. But I can't get through to anyone. I hope nothing happened to her. She's going all bobblehead. Oh, you calming it down now? Okay. Okay, quit the boblin. Quit it. Alright, so can't get in touch with her. What about you, sir? Hello, young lady. You seem quite tired. Are you alright? Why, yes, we are. Yeah, we're alive and all that stuff. That's all very good. Don't let yourself get in a panic now. Gotta keep looking on the bright side. To be honest, this is the kind of situation that almost makes me feel excited. Your neck isn't getting itchy by any chance, Mr. Sunshine, is it? No? Alright, nothing else from him? And, let me double check with Kelly. Just need to make sure that's the last thing she had to say. Yeah. Okay, that is. Alright, Vigo! Old artificial eye friend, how's it going? I'm awfully sorry that things came to this. Huh, surely there's no need for you to apologize. But there is, because I'm here to kill you all. Oh, there is. I'm Vigo Borotsov, the owner of this ship. And yet I don't have a clue what's happening or why. I'm responsible for everything that happens on this ship. Yeah, of course you are, Vigo. Totally don't suspect you of nothing. Oh, come on, that can't be the only thing he has to say. You mentioned that you're the owner of the ship, right? So you wouldn't happen to know a way off this floor, right?
Off this floor? Don't tell me you're contemplating leaving this room.
There's someone I want to find. It's important. I need to go get Monica.
Reckless for sure, but perhaps that is precisely the kind of person who may something escape here, I'm guessing?
Question mark?
Question mark. If you go to the end of the floor, to the end of the aisle in the movie theater, you'll find a door leading to the emergency elevator. You should be able to get to the other floors from there. Here, take this key.
Why, thank you, you creepy fucker. Anything else?
Emergency stairwell, yes, okay, very well. Good, thank you for listening to me.
Shouldn't everybody be, like, freaking the fuck out around him by now? Because, I mean, Leonard? Oh. Hey, Monica's thing! Okay, so Monica's... Okay, sweet, yeah, but Leonard posted this. This is there. Okay, so... Yeah, so Monica should be with, Itches by now, right? Below deck? She shouldn't be up here anymore. Wonder if we can go down. I don't know, we should probably go... up first. Because I want to go back and, like, look at the other rooms real quick. And, you know, make sure nothing's changed in there. Because things changed before. Like, when we were playing as Monica, you know, we went back to the cafe or the bar or whatever, and, you know, things were different in there. I don't remember if there was anything for us to find, per se, but, you know, just want to go look and check it out. See all the cool new stuff lying around for us. Probably lots of blood and dead bodies. We'll be careful not to click on anything too suspicious, I'm sure. You know, so as not to summon a scissor walker. Just gonna charge our phone. Save before we do anything stupid, right? And we will get our butts upstairs. Alright, let's go see if we can see anything new. After all, the scissor walker did chase us out of there. Before anything interesting happened. Who knows? Maybe this is all locked. Maybe there's nothing for us to find upstairs. Nope, it's open. But yeah, the scissor walker, like, you know, chased us clean out of here. And then the phone call interrupted us before we went up here. Okay, that's Jerome's room. I don't know. Should we look in there? I remember he had, like, a door or something off to the side of his TV, but... I don't know if that goes anywhere. Oh, this isn't ominous in the slightest. Maybe this wasn't a good idea. Like, maybe we should not have come back to this room. Okay. Anything all good in here? Shallow amount of water. Insect wings are bobbing, huh? Are those butterfly wings? No, maybe moth wings. But shit, that ain't good. We know somebody who likes to, pick wings off of bugs. I do not want him around us, and he shouldn't be around us if he's off with Monica. Unless Monica's up here. Shit. The door! Surely not. What do we got here?
What's this? Nothing on the desk other than stationery, ballpoint pens, some complimentary amenities. Uh-huh. Anything else? Like, was this room just here for nothing? There's something. Something on the bed. Bed is made and appears untouched. Well, that is delightful. Why the hell? I don't know. I wonder. Maybe not. I don't know. Does that seem like a hiding spot? Because before we just, like, you know, went out the door, booked it straight out the over there and stuff. But what if we could have hidden in there? I mean, it is a bed. Should have space under it. That's all locked up. What about over here? This wasn't locked up. Let's see. Anything interesting in here? Just got the pool. Some blood. Several billiard balls are, all over the ball. If I remember correctly, the pool is played with 9 balls. Quite a few of them, huh? Well, I suppose. If you pay attention to that sort of thing. What's this? A wet circular impression on the table. It looks like someone is drinking here. Oh, look! Was it- Oh no, is that Saul? No wonder our contact info. Didn't see. Whoa! Whoa! Holy shit! Holy shit! Who's playing darts with us? Dodge! Boom! What the fuck, you? Go, 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 go! Holy crap, that was an artful dodge right there. An artful dodge. Oh, nice job, Rooney. Should probably turn that light off. This way, this way, this way! Oh. Oh. I'm going to try something, I'm going to try something. Oh, I hope this works. I hope that's not just like a completely misleading thing over there. Oh, go, 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 go. I don't hear it. Oh, come on. Door! Okay, now I hear it. Come on, come on, come on. Go! Can I not? Shit, it's in here, isn't it? Oh, it is, that fucking thing. It could be clicked. It could be clicked, though. I have just wasted so much stamina. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. We'll get downstairs. We'll find some place new to hide. Let Rooney rest up a bit. Hopefully we can get to- No, don't you die. Okay, good, 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 good. Don't you die on me, girl. We're escaping this shit. There's the store downstairs. There's potentially this thing over here. Oh, you go, 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 go. And she can't hide there. Of course not. I overestimated her abilities. Go slowly, ever so slowly. I hope we can hide behind that counter. You need to go just a wee bit faster, girl. Just a wee bit faster. You're like right there. Over in there, come on. Yeah? Oh, seriously? I can't? What about there? Yeah, yeah. That works. We know not to go over there. But get in there. Hopefully this works. Hopefully there's nothing creepy back here waiting for us to die. Oh, go away. Go away, scissors. We're not here. Oh, shoo. Shoo! Get out of here. Fucking asshole. Yeah, that's right. You leave us. Whew, and no quick time either. Yeah! Kick ass! Oh, wow. I am proud of her. She's really stepping up, isn't she? She's almost Monica-worthy. Yeah, but she's stepping up big time. Like, you know.
She's like, I'm going to go find Monica and learn Jessica, even though Jessica's fucking dead. We're going to save everybody and gonna freaking bullet time dodge those, what was it? Oh yeah, darts. She bullet time dodged darts, and that's pretty kick-ass. I should recharge my smartphone, just in case, because, you know, Sister Walker's just fucking popping out bodies, tossing darts at us like a freaking... No. Seriously, though, that was... I was not expecting, you know, dart games with the Scissor Walker. Mind you, he has proven her, she, or it, or whatever the fuck you want to call this thing. Because I'm still trying to figure out if it's, like, supposed to be an extension of Rooney's spirit. You know, is, kind of a creative soul, I think, this monster. Because, let's, like, think back on all the different bodies we've discovered. You had the one stuffed in the freezer, you had the one dangling from the ceiling fan, and, you know, you just have all these things, these bodies that we're finding, they're kind of displayed, almost. It's like, it's almost like it's a sick child toying with toys, you know, like a baby bitch ghost, those kind of things. I'm pretty sure the baby bitch ghost is a separate entity from the, you know, Scissor Walker, but still. You weren't happening to hold any, phones, were you? Yep, it is most definitely Saul. It's punctured by a dozen darts. It's such a grim sight. Oh, and we're going to get all... Did you kiss him? Okay, searching the chest pocket. Okay! Keycard! Well, that's freaking dandy. Let's see what else we could find. Someone has left an unfinished bottle of whiskey. Okay. Maybe the whiskey could help me forget what's happening. Probably not a good idea. Yeah, don't go getting drunk. The last thing we need is for you stumbling and drunk. You'd be twice as stumbly. Just think about it. It would be terrible, Rooney. You don't have the constitution to handle this as is. Just be making it worse on yourself. Now, let's see if we can go back to the dining hall. Perhaps, where the party was. Can we go back there? Okay, we cannot go back there. Nothing for us to click on. There wasn't anything on this side, was there? I don't think there was. I think that one room is locked up. So, okay, that should be it for up here, I think. Unless, I mean, there is that place at the end of the hall, but it just looks like it's roped off. Oh no, let's go check it out. Let's go check it out. We don't have that much time anyway, might as well. Investigate all that we can investigate. Yeah, this over here, we never messed with any of that. Wait, is that something? It is! This is new. What do we got over here? We never saw this. This level is so freaking huge, it's ridiculous. Like, what is this now? I guess 3 episodes that we've spent trying to explore this crap? Or 2. I mean, technically 2. But, it could be 3, because we did kind of see some of the stuff in Rooney's room. I mean, not Rooney's room, Jerome's room. It's an old beaten-up jukebox, seen bare years. None of the lights adorning its frame are working, so it's probably just intended for show or something. I don't know. I guess. What we got there? That looks important. There's a ball on the counter. It's a little larger than a ping-pong ball. Upon careful inspection, the ball has a number printed on it. It's another billiard ball! I wonder if it's... someone took it from the game room. Billiard ball C. How many billiard balls do we have? What the fuck? What the fuck? I'm not going to investigate that! What the hell? Looks like some water spilled on the glass on this table. Oh, that's... Oh, that was lucky! That could have been really bad. Actually, no. Let's not click on that, but I will show you guys. That is a freaking coat hanger with arms shoved on it. Oh, gotta be careful not to click too many bloody things. That could be terrible. This fucking monster. It's something. Like, I don't even. It's been playing puppets with dead bodies. It's been hanging corpses from the ceiling fans. It's a ball. This monster's a ball. And can't do anything there. Looks like a nice service elevator. Wait, no, he said it was by the movie theater, didn't he? I was like, wait, can we use the key there? But no. He said whatever it was by the theater. So let's go back to the theater. See if we can get that all done. Because I'm pretty sure we've cleared out everything up here. And we've cleared out everything down there. We did that last time. And so now to go clear out everything by the movie theater. So we found Kelly over there. We found... Yeah, we just found... I'm pretty sure we got everything. Like, I don't know. Point it... If you know something, point it out. But pretty sure we got everything. Alright, let's just save one last time, and then we will probably have- Yeah, we'll have to end the episode here, but let's just take a minute and discuss some things, like Vigo being in the apartment thing, and nobody- Not an apartment, the storage room. I meant compartment, but... Anywho, Vigo's off in the storage room with everybody, despite Leonard's warning of, you know, beware anybody with a freaking fake-ass eye. And then I noticed this before when we were going through the address book, but Saul was not in there despite us getting that. I don't know if I mentioned it in previous episode. I'm pretty sure I did when we got Kelly, right? I don't know. I don't remember too well. But, yeah, but we do still have his thing on the SNS. But yeah, he is super dead. Super, super dead. Golly. You think he would have hid himself better? He had so many places to hide in there. And then he just gets darted to death. How does that work? And why won't you let me hide behind you, counter? Why? Oh! On the counter is a single sheet of paper covered- Whoa, okay, passenger names. Maybe these are the passengers who came to the theater? Okay, something- Why are you marked off, Kita? Okay, well, I was not expecting to actually find anything there. I guess that's why we had the click option. I thought it was the place to hide. I thought it was, you know, somewhere we could duck behind, but it has proven time and time again that it's not there for me to hide behind. But yeah, Rooney is shaping up to be a better character. She might be baby-voiced and very awkward and all that crap, but she is proving to be quite the badass because, you know, she's taken after Monica. She's all like, let's go find people and let's, you know, save the day and all that good stuff. And bullet time dodge. I'm serious. I cannot get over that freaking dart dodge. That was the coolest shit. I would have loved to see Monica do that, but Rooney did it. And so therefore Rooney gets extra brownie points. But yeah, this is where we're going to end the episode. So, you know, like and subscribe if you want to, and thank you for watching.